Well, hello everyone. Back again to continue on this drawing. And this is going to be the first in a series because it is done without time lapse. So if you find it to be a little bit on the slow side for you, you may want to turn up your YouTube speed. Otherwise, I'm breaking this up into multiple videos so that we can keep it not too long, and we can have it relatively at normal speed. I might move it up a little bit, but not enough to affect your ability to see exactly what I'm doing. And I will narrate from here and there within the video when there's a piece of information that I can share with you. So without further ado, let's go into the intro. All right, so what I'm going to do here is start off with the eye. And the first thing I do is grab my darkest charcoal pencil. Now, any soft charcoal pencil will do. Don't need a particular brand. I know people ask me, what brand do you use? You know, what kind should we take, you know, and do this and that. Really, whatever soft, dark, charcoal pencil you have will do just fine. So just grab one. And I'm going to start with the dark areas of the eye. Now, first off, is I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here so you can see this a lot better. Much better. Okay. So I'm starting with the pupil here, and you want this to be pitch black. You don't want any paper to show through it whatsoever. And I'm going to use this charcoal pencil for all the very dark areas of this eye. It'll be around the edge of the iris of the eye, the pupil of the eyelashes, the areas just under the eye lashes where there's shadow, anywhere that you see in the photo that is pitch black, I will use my darkest soft charcoal pencil. And I'll go ahead and just put the particular charcoal pencil that I'm using down in the description below for those who still want to know which one I happen to be using here. Okay. At this point, I realize that this grid is in my way. And I want to be able to see all the details, even whatever's underneath those lines. So I'm going to move this grid out of my way. I don't have any use for it now. The initial sketch is down. All is good as far as proportions are concerned. And so now I need to start drawing details, shading, blending, all that good stuff. The actual bulk of this drawing. So time to move this grid. Okay, you might have caught that where I had some charcoal dust on my paper and then miraculously it just disappeared. And that's because I blew on it. And I want to tell you that because if you do that, you have to be very, very careful that you do not accidentally cause any kind of moisture from your mouth to get on the paper. So you want to be very careful when blowing on your paper. I do it all the time. Now, as I'm drawing the outer iris here, I wanna make sure that it is perfectly rounded. It doesn't have any kind of odd, you know, straight edges or things sticking out of the eye that really shouldn't be there. So, as I go along, I'll refine the edge of the eye to make sure that it is perfectly nice and smooth and round. But right now, I just kind of roughed it in. Now, the pencil that I'm using now is a hard, or actually it's an extra hard charcoal pencil. And I will use this for the very fine details. I will also use it, as in this case, to give myself a nice sharp edge. Okay, now right here, I'm using my Tombow Mono Zero eraser pen just to clean the edges up a little bit. I don't care if there's a little shadow left behind because I use very dark charcoal, because that will just play into the blur that I'm going to end up giving it later on. Now, most of the proportion work was done drawing the initial sketch. However, I like to make sure that the proportions are correct even during drawing. I'll use this proportional divider here just to make sure that everything is correct. Sometimes I may have left out some initial sketch line or something, and so it's always a good idea to just check and double check. I will admit that one of the toughest things about drawing something like this is that this isn't an enlargement. This drawing is 50% larger than the original photo. And the way my eye and mind work is I tend to draw exactly what I see, and that includes all the proportions and dimensions, thicknesses, every detail exactly the way I see it. But in this case, I can't do that. I have to compensate for the enlargement itself. And so I have to double check and make sure that I am in fact drawing it 50% larger and can't just rely on the initial sketch lines that I have here, because there are areas of details, very small details, like a little freckle or something like that, which I would not put in there in my initial sketch, but I'm going to have to add when I'm doing the actual drawing here. And so I'm going to have to go in and make sure to measure that I am in fact blowing it up by 50%. And that just makes this whole process a little harder. And I will admit that I won't be doing a whole lot of these enlargement type drawings. In fact, my wife said, "Where do you think you're going to be hanging up a large drawing like that one?" So I don't even know if I'm going to have wall space because my wife's going to put her foot down. So usually I'm going to draw the same size as the original photo. And as far as these enlargements, if I don't enlarge the photo, like I did not enlarge the photo here, It's going to just take a little more time and effort to make sure that I have all the details correct. Now, you see me kind of drawing a few eyelashes here, but those are not actually going to be the final eyelashes. I'm just getting my, you might say, my bearings straight here as to where these items, these details are going to end up being in the final drawing. So I lightly just drew a few of the lashes in there just so that I have an idea where I am in this sketch, and to make sure that everything is being drawn in the right locations. So that's all that is. Okay, I'm using a paper blender here because I don't want to be as dark as a soft charcoal. I want to have a lighter charcoal but smooth effect. And so I'll just push it around with this blender, and then I could use this blender as a drawing tool as I go on. Now, I think it's important to note that eyes are the white of the eye is never white, and it's a lot of beginning artists have trouble with this. They leave their eyeballs really white, and that's just not natural. And what I like to do is I will use the existing charcoal or graphite, whatever I happen to have already drawn, and I will blend that out towards the iris of the eye, so that as I get closer to the eye, it tends to go lighter and lighter. And if it doesn't, then I will of course come in with my kneaded eraser and start lightening it up around the iris. You see, the area of the eye that is closer to us, the viewer, is going to be lighter than the outside of the eye around the lid area, where it should be slightly darker. And this gives the eye that round look to it, like it's an eyeball rather than it being flat. So you can see that I'm reapplying some extra hard charcoal down by the tear duct, but then I'm going to blend it out towards the iris. And so the white of the eye itself will no longer be white, but it will be a lighter shade of gray in comparison to the outer part of the eyeball, and that just gives it that rounded look. So you'll notice I'll be doing this from time to time throughout this video, where I'm just going to get that shading down so that it goes darker as you move away from the iris of the eye. Okay, now I had to put my charcoal pencil on an extender because I'm down to a stub. The thing about these soft charcoal pencils, they wear down really fast. You have to keep sharpening them. And I like to use every little bit that I can, even after I can no longer fit it in a pencil sharpener. I'll still use it to use it against a Q-tip, which you'll see later in this video, where then I can, you know, use it for blending purposes. So I try to get every little bit of use out of my pencil. Now, I really like the use of my blender. In this case here, I'm taking the dark charcoal with the blender and pushing it out away from the eye so that it provides just a slightly lighter shade of dark as you move away from the crease of the eyelid. And then from there, I'll probably pick up a Q-tip or maybe a clean end of the paper blender to continue outwards, as the skin is going to be a little lighter than this dark shadowed shaded area. Thank you. Yes, here's where I've picked up a Q-tip, and then I'm going to continue on where I left off with the paper blender and just kind of push that charcoal outwards into the skin area so that it's kind of a nice even transition from the deep recesses of the eyelid out into the open, where of course, you know, is a much flatter area of the skin. And if you look at the reference photo, look how dark this reference photo is. The skin is dark, the shadows are dark, everything's dark. So you don't want to be afraid to go dark. And so I will push this drawing to be dark, just like the photo, and that will give it true photorealism. That's why I'm kind of sticking right now with the charcoal for these areas. But as I go into the lighter area of the face, I'm going to possibly use some graphite powder, or I might continue on with the charcoal. We'll see how this goes. Thank you. Okay, and now I'm going to take my electric eraser and I'm going to just kind of touch up the highlight areas in here to really bring them out. This really makes the eye look real because you have light just glaring off of it in contrast to the dark areas that are adjacent to these highlighted areas here. And it just has a wonderful effect in realism.
Thank you.
Now, here's what I mentioned earlier in the video, where you're going to want to kind of diffuse the outer rim of the iris just a wee bit. And I'm doing it here with this paper blender. I am just kind of bringing it out a little bit. And I'll zoom it in here for you. Just notice how subtle that blur is, just on the edge of the iris itself, ever so lightly. Thank you. Well, that brings us to the end of this part of the video, this part of the process. And in the next video, we'll continue on with the next step of this drawing. And I'll see you then. Thanks for watching.